Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I have three foil cards for you and I'm going to play with the new color by Tim Holtz and I will combine it with some foiling fun. I have here the October foiling kit by Spellbinders. In this kit this month you will get this lovely border of leaves which is perfect for all your foil cards but you can easily use it all year round. It creates this arch that you can have at the top or at the bottom of your card or you can foil it twice so you will have a border all around. You will get two extra plates as sentiments. The one says Happy Fall Y'all and the other one Hello Pumpkin. And you will also get this gold roll of foil. Today I'm going to create three backgrounds using ink blending techniques and I will be working on all three of them with the new Distress Oxide color, which is Crackling Campfire. So I'm going to share three different color combos that work great for foil cards. I'm going to do all my blending with these big brushes, blending brushes by Altenew, just because they cover up completely a big area really quickly. And I'm going to start with Wild Honey. With the lightest color, I'm going to completely cover up the whole area. This way, it's going to make it easy for me to blend the next colors that I'm going to add. And now I'm going to bring in Crackling Campfire. This is the new color. I'm going to bring it in from the edges towards the center without covering up the center. This blends nicely with the color that I have underneath and I like the look because by having the center lighter, it's going to look as if it is glowing. I'm going back to Wild Honey and I'm going to blend one more time over where those two colors meet so you get a very smooth blending. Now finally I'm going to go to the darkest of the colors that I grabbed and that's Ground Espresso and I'm going to add some darker edges. For that I'm using a smaller brush since I don't want to go as far towards the center as I did with Crackling Campfire. So here is the first background. I'm going to create two more and then I'm going to turn them into cards. For my second background, I'm starting with Fossilized Amber, again a lovely shade of yellow. Then I'm going to move on to Crackling Campfire and yellow with orange go lovely together. You will see that I will be able to eliminate completely that line where those two colors touch. And finally, I'm going to finish it off with some Fired Brick. Also notice that I don't have as many brushes as my colors, obviously. I have just a few and I keep using them for the same color families. I just clean up my brush on a paper towel roll. And I never had issues with contaminating one ink pad from another. And here is a look on my second background. And finally, let's create a third color combo. For the first one, if you notice, I did have lighter at the center and as I go to the outside, darker. For the second one, I went on an ombre, top to bottom. For the third one, I'm going to go completely random. And I have to say that this background turned out really gorgeous, probably my favorite from all three. Let me know in the comments below which one of the backgrounds was your favorite. Here I'm mixing three different colors. And I'm bringing in a little bit of green this time. So the three colors that I used are Rusty Hinge, Crackling Campfire, and Forest Moss. In the beginning, it's going to look like a mess, but I was determined to make it work and you will see that it's going to blend nicely and it's going to give a lovely look. The fun part about working with Distress Oxide ink is that the ink stays on top of the paper, so it makes it really easy to blend. I also have to say that for these three backgrounds I was working on watercolor paper, which makes blending Distress Oxide inks even easier. Now to complete the messy look that I'm going for, I'm going to add some water splashes. Again, this is Distress Oxide on top of watercolor paper, which means that it's going to lift color a lot. I'm going to leave it for a few seconds to react, and here is the finished look. I absolutely loved that, and I'm going to add some extra splashes here. So here is my favorite fall background, and now let's turn all three of them into cards. For my first card, I'm working with the background that has the light at the center. I'm going to secure at the top the border with the leaves. I will use the same foil roll that was included in the kit, that's the golden one. And I'm going to repeat the same process twice, so I will end up having a border of leaves all around. So after the plate was nice and warm, I ran it through my die cutting machine. I always like to do that twice. I'm going to peel off the foil so you will be able to see the lovely result. And then I'm going to do the same thing one more time. If you like to play with distress oxide inks or any other inks to create backgrounds, then I believe that this border is the perfect one for creating quick and simple cards. At the same time, they do add lots of interest on your background with that shine. And all then you have to do is to just add a sentiment at the center. For this card, I'm going with Happy Fall Ye All, which again, I'm going to foil with the same foil roll. And you can stick this panel on top of a pre-folded card and you will be ready to go. If you want to take it a step further, then you can use a circle die, just like I did here, to cut out the center. You can pop it on top of your card just for a little bit of dimension. For my card here, you will see that I have quite of an empty space when I pop the circle inside. That's because I used two circle dies, one inside the other. This way I am able to see the background color, and of course I went with dark brown. You can embellish the leaves a little bit with gems or little nouveau drops. I'm going to leave it as it is, and here are some close-up photos. When I share cards with foiling, I always have to say it is really difficult to catch that shine on camera, but in real life they look really stunning and professional. For my second card, I created one more panel, exactly like I did for the first card, but this time I used the copper foil roll that I had in my stash, just a warmer tone of color. I did that on craft colored cardstock, and for the background, I chopped the two sides so that I will be able to see the border coming through. Now, to embellish my card, I did stamp a few pumpkins that I had in my stash. I'm sure pretty much everyone has a couple of pumpkin stamps, which I'm going to color with my Prismacolor pencils. I'm using the technique where you apply color on the craft cardstock and then you blend everything with Gamsol. On today's video, I'm mainly focusing on the blended backgrounds as well as on foiling, so I'm not going to share in extent how I did color the pumpkins. However, it is a really fun technique and I did share that in previous videos. Now it's time to put my card together. If you notice, for the pumpkins I didn't went with orange. I like the pumpkins to be white, and that's because I do have enough orange at the background. I wanted to have something that would stand out against that. So for the sentiment, I went with a foiled plate that I had in my stash from previous kits, and that says thanks for everything. I think this would make the perfect Thanksgiving card. But remember, in this foil kit for this month, you will get a sentiment that says Hello Pumpkin, which would go great with this design as well. So I'm going to stick the pumpkins on top, and this is going to finish off my card. You can see here some close-up photos, and hopefully you will be able to see the shine on the sentiment as well as on the borders. And finally, let's move on to the third background for today. For this, I did foil that border twice on a piece of black cardstock, and now I'm going to do some fuzzy cutting. So I'm going to cut out leaves from this design, and I'm cutting exactly where that foiled line is, so without leaving any border. And this way I will end up having some foiled elements that I can pop on my card. Now, another way to go is to use your scissors and cut out all around that arch. This will give you the opportunity to pop it on top of your card if you like. So for this card, I used the same foil, this is the copper one, and foiled the word October. This comes from a previous set where I get all the names of the months. And I have some foam tape at the back. I'm going to stick it on top of my card. And I die cut the word hello out of craft cardstock. So my whole sentiment will read Hello October. You can go with Happy October or use any other sentiment combination depending on what you find on your stash. Now I'm going to use those cut out leaves with the foiling and I'm going to embellish this sentiment underneath. I'm firstly going to play around, decide where I want these to be, and then I'm going to stick them down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue. With my fingers, I'm giving some curve on the leaves so that they have a little bit of dimension and movement. And I absolutely love how those foiled black elements pop against the background. To put my card together, I'm working on a pre-folded white card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to stick on the two sides those black strips of cardstock. These are just scraps that I had on my table, and my background panel turned out to be slightly smaller than the standard card. So on the left and on the right, you will be able to see those black borders. And I finished off my card by adding some copper gems around the leaves. And these were all the three cards that I made for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. You will find the links to everything I used down below in the description area. And I hope you will all have a lovely day.